of first time, only few are there, right? So for them, I would just say that it would be a little bit hectic, because when I first participated, it was for the next 1 week, I had cramps in my calves, thighs, and everywhere. So it will be.
How many kilometers did
you run? It was 10. My first attempt was 10. So.
And what if you practice?
Just a quick information that about the diet, what you should follow before the night, before the running night, before the D-Day. It should be like you should have a complete light diet. It can be anything, not in high protein, high carb, all those things, not much like that, not any sweets or any of those things. Just have light food. If anybody use any type of protein shake, you can have that in night, or any type of thing which you can include in water, like you can make shake by yourself using oats and bananas and all those things, or any type of energy drink you can use, you can have that a night before that. Try to have your dinner by 7 or by 8, max by 8, not after that, because you will get a proper gap in between your running time and the diet. And in morning, many people would say that you can have one banana or two banana, but I would say don't have very much amount of food, because they are citrus in nature. You might get cramp in your belly or stomach, you might get cramp over there. Fruits cause those things. You can have two biscuit or something like that, or one bread. With that you can have one banana, so it will be light also, and you can have something to sustain your energy throughout the run. So this is just a tip from my side. Any question regarding diet or anything? Anything you want to ask?
Can we have milk before?
No, I would prefer no. You should not have milk before running. I think you know that. You're also in the generation.
I just wanted to add your point in your review.
So yeah, anything more you want to ask regarding the workouts or anything before the running? A day before that, I would say a day before that you should not do any workout. You should have a complete rest. Anything, any workout or anything, you should complete it by today evening or by day after tomorrow, or my means tomorrow morning. You should complete your workouts or everything.
Should we avoid a daily walk? Means,
no, you can do that.
Daily 3 kilometers if we are going.
Daily 3 kilometers, it's good if don't go in the evening, I would say.
Okay.
Because you should give your legs and your complete body a rest period, so that the next day you don't get exhausted in the beginning only.
I would also add some more points here.
Yep.
So basically, Rohan says that Saturday should be a rest day. That is mandatory. Plus, your schedule is also important. So I've been practicing for marathon like 6 months, 8 months. So first thing is that you need a rest day. Second thing, your schedule must be important. So basically, if you want to go for a marathon at 5 a.m. or 6 a.m., you need to sleep at 11 p.m. You cannot stay awake after that, because you need at least 6 hours of sleep, because our body is not used to it, right? So just in case if I'm running 10K, I'm not practicing that, I need at least 6 hours of sleep. You also need rest. You can walk sometimes, but you should not run. You would take rest on Saturday. That is mandatory. And things like he added, like you can eat. What I do is I eat one banana 30-40 minutes prior to the run, and that's all. Maybe drink water or something with you, but that's all.
And yeah, one more point, as you said about the water, you should have lots of water a day before that, so that your body don't get dehydrated on the running day. You should have at least. For the girls, I would say it should be about 3 to 4 liters, and for the boys, it should be about 5 to 6 liters. In that, you should keep it. If you increase the amount after that also, it will not be a problem, but have plenty of water so that your body don't get exhausted on the running day.
Very good point, Ron, but one question is, why do we have a difference of like
discrimination?
It's not discrimination, it's the body type we have. Means the muscle quantity in men is different from the muscle quantity present in women. So for that thing, and the muscle cramp you will also get, it also depends on the amount of water we have in our body. If the water is drained out from our body, then the salt get saturated only few points of our muscles area. So on those points you will get the cramps. That's why.
And one more thing that I want to add, like Siddharth, you said that you will reach there around 6:30, because 6:40 is the flag of time. So that's the reason I want you to come 30 minutes prior, because pre-warm-up is important, and after the run also warm-up, like stretching is important, because if you just go on there and run, your body, your muscles are not used to it, right? You just wake up, freshen up and just go and run. You will get a lot of cramps, so you will be in pain for next 2-3 days. So basically,
there can be any vital injuries also, like you might have some joint injuries also, because you don't know the track. It might be some high altitude might be there, some low altitude might be there, so you might get any type of knee joints problem or anything can happen if you don't get a good warm up before that.
Just one suggestion. As you know that after the marathon, the cool down is important. If you all can organize, we can gather around there, and if you, Aditya, can do the cool down, and we will follow you.
We will surely do that. We will do that before the run and after the run.
After the run.
Before the run, they will also do. So
yeah, they will. Correct.
Yeah. So after the run, it will be important.
We will do that.
So we can assemble at one point at the selfie place. So Aditya will help us.
Yeah, sure. That sounds good.
Run time will be different.
Yeah.
I think by 8 or 8:30 most of by 8 I think everyone should be done, because most for 10k flag of time is 6:40, so at most it will take after having breakfast and also. I think by 8 everyone should be done. We'll do some stretching for 25-30 minutes and we can leave by 8:30 or 9.
So our accessories and everything you have to keep.
They have lockers. Plus, I think it's better to keep, like, we have like few cars with us. I think Sagar will be having cars, so it is better to keep your like phones and wallets in their cars. I prefer not to use lockers and try not to bring like
any accessories.
Just bring your phone, wallet, like, these necessities.
And there is a request, means if all the person can come can collect today only, then it would be very very helpful. So that we can distribute today only. At the day of this marathon, it's become little hard for us to distribute the bills there. So share this to the concerned people. If your friend is running, then tell him that get by today only.
That's it. Any other queries? Sir?
You have anything about the marathon?
Sagar, do you want to add anything?
Okay. I mean, how many of you have actually run the marathon?
This is your first time?
First time.
Okay, you all have participated for 5K, right?
Yes.
Okay. So have you practiced other?
Yes.
Okay, what is your longest distance that you do in one attempt?
One attempt?
Yeah.
5 minutes.
So you can run for
yes,
complete 5K,
I
right?
Yeah.
Okay. So those who have
not
challenges
walking and running.
Yeah, that's fine. See, the walking is not a shameful act during marathon, and it is not a marathon actually. Marathon is actually called who runs for 42K.
Yes.
Okay, so this is not a marathon that we are just participating in a running event. That's it, nothing beyond that. So ensure that don't stress yourself, even if you feel burnt out and all that. Just stay calm, take a walk. You can also get down, sit down someplace for 2-3 minutes, and then again take a walk. The moment your legs are warmed up, start running. And you need not run too fast or too slow, just at a moderate pace that keeps your breath for a longer duration. You don't breathe out for very short. Ritesh, Sagar is there, he also runs 10K and 21K. So anybody who run in group, that will help you most. If you try to run solo, you will have a hard time concentrating on your mind that you need to run and all that. So run in a group so that you are surrounded by people, and then the other space keeps you busy and engaged, and it keeps you away from the thought that you are breathing out. That most likely to happen. Sometimes the mind takes over you. So to avoid that, run in a group. That's most important. Anybody who's running for 10K, again, just walk whenever you feel you're short of breath. Don't put too much of pressure on your heart. It is dangerous. There have been instances where the pro runners who have been doing 42K, come across with cardiac arrest during the marathon while they were running. So we are not pros. So keep easy.
Thank you.
That's all, nothing else. And as far as the kit collection is concerned, if you know your some of your colleagues would have also participated, so collect it on their behalf so that we have less burden on us to distribute it on the day of the event. Because tomorrow, I'm not sure we have any plan to distribute anything. No, right? Yeah. So everybody will have to collect it today or on the event day. So that's about it.
We have the kids here?
Yeah, we have the kids.
Let's start this morning.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Y